Okay, done. So you can start. I will mute and just one thing. I will have to leave maybe 10 minutes before the ending of the session, okay?
Sorry?
I will have to leave like 10 minutes before, but I will leave
okay,
the session
no
because...
Perfect.
Okay, I see that two more persons are connecting, so let's maybe wait for them. Ruben, good morning.
Hello, good morning, everyone.
Hello. And someone else is getting connected. Well, maybe I can do a brief recap of what the acceleration program will work. Hi, Luis. Well, Luis is from Nabladoc and Ruben is from Bopu. If I remember correctly, Ruben, your company participated in Reconcel, and Luis, your company participated in Cloud SME.
You're right.
Okay. So I was explaining before, okay, I will do just a brief recap because I was explaining to Siga before that during this training program that we have prepared for the beneficiaries of I4MS, there will be different webinars. The one of today is on marketing for thresholds and events. And there will be others that you have received a one pager about it. And then after each webinar, if you would like to have one-to-one sessions with the trainers, with the mentors, please let us know. You will be able to select up to three different mentors to have these one-to-one sessions, okay, on the different topics that will be covered during the training. So please, after a webinar, if you would like to receive more information on the topics, let us know, and we will organize these one-to-one meetings for you, okay?
Perfect. Going on, then once you have defined the goals, then it's time to check the wallet. It really depends on it. If you have a bigger budget, you can actually afford to go to more events.
Juan, don't see the PPT on the screen.
Okay. Now?
Not yet.
What do you see in the screen?
I see like the name of the call, but nothing else. Can you see it, or is a problem of my computer? Because perhaps you can see it.
Yeah, I think you have to share the presenter role again, because it's waiting. It's written waiting to see the funding box screen.
Okay.
Okay. Say that.
We will just restart.
Now?
No. Now better?
I cannot see.
So in principle we have the presenter role, and it says that we are not yet sharing the screen.
Maybe now. Do you see it now?
No.
In principle, as a part, it should be seen.
No, we still don't see it.
Okay, let us give us a second.
Maybe if we close it.
Let me do just one thing. I will change the presenter and I will give you access once again. Okay, so let's see if this way it works. No, I cannot grant you access for some reason. Okay.
Okay. Welcome to this workshop on marketing tips for traditions and events. This is Juan Antonio Pavón, Mobile World Capital EU Project Executive, working mostly in communication. And here's my colleague Marta Portales.
Hello, I'm also working on different European projects in Robot Union, which also we manage the communication part there, Impact Growth and NGI.
What we will learn today will be about creating a marketing strategy for trade shows. In it, we will design the showcase, we will work with the public relations strategy, also the media strategy, the digital strategy as well, and then how to evaluate the event after the show. Then we'll have some conclusions. Firstly, we need to know what we want. For that, we need to set up objectives and goals. If you don't have your own methodology yet, we offer you the possibility to go to the SMART methodology. You can actually go and Google it, but just a brief explanation of it. It's to make yourself some questions about how specific your goals are, how measurable, how attainable, how relevant, and how time-bound they are. If you need more information about that, just let us know and we will actually give us further training on this. Secondly, once you have set up these goals, you have to design the budget. How to figure out how much money do you have or how much money you don't have. For that, once you establish the budget, there are a few possibilities. If you are not so wealthy, we offer you the possibility to find partnerships. Marta have
in that regard there's always the governments and the countries have programs in which they organize delegations that go around the world to different world-class events that are interesting for different sectors and make yourself aware of all these open calls that the governments do in order to pay for your booths. For example, in the case of Spain, Acció in Catalunya brings to other parts of the world different startups that are developing technologies that are interesting, and usually they look for only Spanish startups. So the same applies for Japan. I know they have delegations and they tend to come to 4 years from now. There are also other countries that also try to foster this inside their countries.
All the regions, mostly, they have their own platforms. For example, if you work in, maybe, let's make an example, in Flanders, there is the Flanders Market organization. In it, you can actually join, partner, and then you can actually just find support to attend events. Also, your own partners, your daily, the companies you work daily with, you can also try to join a budget and set up your own common strategy. Once you have defined the budget, it's critical to choose the right events. Don't go for the really big ones if you don't have a really relevant product, or nor go to the small ones because you will actually make expense and you don't really have any impact. You have to be really wise and choose in a case-by-case scenario, just also taking into account the two previous steps and up to that defining where to go.
It's also very important to check the event page and see who is behind the event, who is doing it, and see the partners that are, usually they update the event page all the time and you can start seeing who are the exhibitors and who are the partners that are giving money to the event in order to establish partnerships and see if that is something that would interest you.
Watch out, because at the moment there is a lot of companies making, in brackets, fake events in which they want money and they stand running it. I mean, it's not that you are going to get scammed, but maybe the event get canceled because there is not enough people, and well, this is actually a really new scenario, so just watch out and make sure that the event you are going to attend is a real solid one. Once this has been set up, now we go to design the communication strategy, which entails the public relations strategy, the media strategy, and the digital one. in which it doesn't matter how many people do we have in the company, we will try to make the biggest noise as possible. Well, first step, designing the showcase, designing the shop, designing the placing in which you are going to be 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, or the length of the event. In it, you will have to be yourself, being the representative of your company, and also bring as much examples of your work and to make it more or less interesting. This is actually basically like a street market in any place of the world. So the first step is to make it visible. People that pass by can actually see what you are offering and can make an idea of what you do just in a second. Make it open and make it accessible. We have seen many, many, many booths in which they have a really nice content, but just for the way they actually set it up, you could not really go inside. This is actually a barrier, and that would make it difficult for people to come in and to just start a chat. Also, very important, it's to have a replicable way of just spreading your message. We think that screens are basics. Even though the event doesn't offer it, or it's really expensive, or you cannot really afford it, don't take a screen yourself, but bring a tablet. This is actually critical. Marta has a few tips for screens.
Yes, exactly. So, for example, in the events, usually they offer you different things like chairs and also screens. And screens usually are really expensive, and it's best that you bring your own iPad with you and you can show there the video, or you can actually buy a screen for those days and then bring it home because it's cheaper than renting one, for example. So there are different ways of hacking the event and tricking your way in. Also, ask always if the event is accepts flyers or not, because there are some events that by now are more eco-friendly and they are free paper zones. So there are papers that are forbidden. So in that case, you would definitely need different ways of trying to promote your business inside those events more creatively, I would say. So the screens, if you bring an iPad where you can show your solution, if it's, for example, a robot, a demo of the robot. Prototypes are also really very nice to have. All the technology that you can bring and show, it's always interesting.
Yeah. Well, this we will talk about this in a second. Finally, going on with the structure of the workshop, we like to talk about the material things you actually give away. About this, we have different perspectives. I mean, there are many, many choices, but you should try to make it reasonably coherent with what you actually do. We have thought, for example, that bags are really useful for the first day because people start seeing that there is someone giving things. People will start wondering who is and where it is. This is actually only useful if it is the first day, right?
The first day, yes. Those bags, the different, yeah.
Okay, then I would say, in my opinion, don't really spend a lot of money on it because there is a lot of people giving things, usually sticks or whatever thing. So if you really want attention from people, bring food, because people is starving, people have been there for like hours, they are tired and they want just a refreshment. So having can of soda or just dried fruit is always always facilitate contact. Coming back to the point that Marta commented, demonstrators. The content you're going to have in the booth. We think demonstrators are really useful because people love to play with things and touch stuff and just make questions out of it. If you have a demonstrator yourself, take it there because it would be super useful. Also, besides that, you can actually go for just plain presentations, which is also makes more difficult. I mean, it's actually more thoughtful when it comes to content, but it's actually harder to take people 20, 30 minutes just watching for what you have to say. Also, you can also participate in the trade show panels by contacting the organization and pushing forward for a place. Or there is also a really nice tool which we normally use, which are tools. Organization and other partners of the event. Many times they organize tours for a specific sort of attendees. Try to check for those, try to apply for those, and try to be visible in the different one of the different stops they offer. Once you have decided this, we have here the really things that you shouldn't do here. Don't improvise. It's actually basic. Don't bring ideas in the last minute. Don't really plan with time. Plan with time and prepare. Prepare. Be creative, but prepare it beforehand. Then don't make a complicated issue. Be simple, because there is a lot of people being seeing a lot of things. So the simple, the easier. Don't overexplain. It's noisy. People is tired and doesn't have really a lot of attention. Practice a one sentence speech. The shorter possible way to explain your idea, your product, or what you do. Then we have an issue, because on one hand, don't leave the stand alone, because people tend to come in the less convenient moment, and then you will miss a contact, a lead, or even a possible future selling. But at the same time, don't stay at the booth the entire day, because as we say, the truth is out there. You have to check information of other people. You have to talk to other people which won't come here. So try to find the balance. The thing is, if you have the resources, please always have one person in the booth, another just walking around. If not, try to organize in order to share the time in the most possible way.
Even some startups that have worked with us that are right now quite big, they usually get one student from the country. For example, if the event is in Israel, so they hire one student in the country, they tell him the pitch and what they have to learn about the company, and afterwards the CEO or the CTO go around and speak with other people. Yeah.
Okay.
Marta, one question regarding to what you have said, and how those companies get in contact with the students in other countries, or?
Yeah, that I don't know, but I can find out. I think there are agencies. Probably they actually talk directly to the organizers of the event, because usually these big tech events have always volunteers that are students from research and also from technical universities, and they get hired by the events in order to volunteer, and sometimes they can also get another contract. So.
Okay.
Probably they ask directly the event organizers. Yeah.
This is very interesting. Thank you.
Okay. Then, don't think you're going to sell there, because people becomes reluctant when they realize that you really are just there for selling. Start to make leads, to make new contacts, and in the best possible scenario, try to make friends. Here we have a little example in the screen below at the right corner. Which one of those couples do you think that will have a more successful contact after the show? Here we have our colleague Anna from BBT, which is actually giving a really hard explanation to this guy on L4MS. And we have two guys taking a picture. So most probably the guys who are taking fun with the picture and the robot will actually have a easier contact there after the show, and we'll have a more successful relationship, working voice. And of course, the last tip, don't forget to have fun, because it's a fair and you have to go there, touch things, play with things, talk to people, eat, drink, and enjoy a bit. Going further, we have the media strategy. Basically, we have here a cost-effective problem. You don't have really a lot of budget, and at the same time, you need to go as much as you can in the media. So it's key to find what the audience or the magazines or the receptors of your information want to know. It's really useful to set up the history about personal stories, or really the benefits for society, or try to find events around to link the content you have with the daily topic. For example, just making up, But for example, if 2 days ago was the World Day of Workers, try to explain with your own technology how this technology will actually make easier for workers to work less or to cease to be more productive or one of those things. Check the media you have around and choose wisely where are you going to put your money or who are you going to contact, because it's time and money and we are not really time or money for spending. Try to, well, to use material for press, mostly PRs, press releases, in which it's a 300-400 words paper in which you actually give away a small piece of information, trying to make the journalist or the editor interested in the information and trying to make him contact back. Don't forget also to put your contact after the information and how they could find easily more information, for example, in the website of your company. Once in the show as well, try to seize the time as much as you can. Record videos, take pictures, and you will actually make use of it in social media, in other events, and so on. Then for commodity and of everyone, your own one, and also the partners that may also have to share this information, we recommend to set up a press toolkit. Here we have an example that we will try to open quickly. Here we put we join all the information we use. Here we have a press release of 5 or less. Together with the place where we were going to be, also information about where to find more information about the, because normally you have to be really careful with the words that you use in the press release, because normally you cannot go further than 300-400, otherwise they automatically discard it. More information about the project, and then together with some Twitter posts that you can use in the future, quickly during the event, also LinkedIn, Facebook posts, pictures of quick use, and that's everything. Then you share it with your partners, your colleagues, your co-workers, and make easy to keep the coherence between all the messages that are shared, and also have a quick tool for retrieving information. Then we come back to the presentation. Well, on public relations strategy as well, you should try to work in advance, like maybe a month before the show, contacting your network and inform them. It's really useful to make an agenda and with all the activities you have defined and spread it. This way you will also connect your existing and you will use it as a key tool in order to regain contact or any other thing you may need. Also, going out of your own ecosystem, finding new potential clients and investors are really useful marketing lists. For that, we would like to suggest hacking tools, for example, PulseHub. In it, I think Marta has more information than me that could share.
Yeah, so for example, sometimes you can use data mining tools. It's a software that goes to the, you can program it to go to the web and access the different contacts and get the emails that are public on the web, and then you can contact the ones that are interesting for you. So we did that for the Mobile World Congress this year, and we have a database right now of 4,000 companies, and the ones that actually had in the catalog the public email, we have access now to those. And that's useful in order to do some contacts. GDPR-wise, this is very important. You only can send them one email, and if they are interested in your solution, then you can send them further emails. But just the first contact is the one that you can do. You cannot do more, so be aware of doing this email very good or very visual. That helps always to add some GIFs at the or videos at the email. So try to do this first contact valuable.
Also, another tip in this first email contact, try to find a formula in which you can actually grant yourself access to availability to send emails. For example, Please, in case you're interested in knowing more, join our newsletter. This way, if they actually join and press the link, you will have a more convenient access and legal access to send them email. Well, then digital strategy. Well, this is actually about interaction with other actors, mostly. All the impression counts, because even though you don't have a click, you will have someone who have seen and read the tweet or the post. So yeah, need to access other ecosystems that are not yours. And what we suggest is about contacting and tagging everyone in the picture. For example, we have a picture here in which it's from right to left. We have Maria here, Merete from DTI, Juan Jauregui from Mobile World Capital, and me myself. So here, for example, we would tag Maria, Merete, and her company, also the company of Maria, or company, also the European Commission, because we see the logos here, as Mobile World Capital, and just by saying how happy we are in the picture. This way, your information goes to everyone's ecosystem who is tagged, and you can actually multiply the impact of your information, the one you want to share. Then, for saving times, we suggest a few tools. Hootsuite is a really useful tool, because there you can actually set up three accounts. And from there you can program all the different actions that you may have may want. For example, if you are busy on Tuesday in the event and you don't have time for that, on Monday you can program a tweet saying the day after whatever thing you want to share. Also, Twitter Deck, if you only work with Twitter, it's really useful, because you can do the same basically in a wider, in a much more user-friendly approach. Also, we have the Venn online platforms, in which they mostly use to find matchmaking. It's really useful. Marta, you have used more than me, I think.
Exactly. The tool that I use the most is Buffer, which is very useful, because you can program at the same time LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, and also Facebook. Although mostly our target is LinkedIn these days, we've done also advertisements with these platforms in order to attract people to our booth. Although I have to say that if you find, if your sector is very specific, like robotics, this is sometimes hard. You have to do an online paid campaign if you have an audience rate that around 200,000 people, because if it's very small, then you won't reach the right people. Also, what works best is to do on Twitter, follow the hashtag of the event, and then do one-on-one messages to the different persons that are attending this event, or the companies that actually have started launching this. So also, everything that Juan was saying, it's important to take into account.
Okay. As conclusion here with digital strategy, this is about making connections. You can do it through hashtags, through tags, through all the apps, through all the tools, but mostly try to connect with people, because also you will open channels of communication in the future if you want to share information about new products. Once they already follow you on Twitter, for example, they will actually always become part of your audience. Well, once the show has finished, it's time to review what things that have been done right and wrong. Mostly, I would recommend to do the evaluation after the following app, as we show here, because also depending on the how successful has been the following apps, it will have it will be successful or not. Call your new friends that you have made during the event, remind them what you have talked with them during the event. And now, if you have to sell, it's time to start the action, not before. Mostly because, everyone knows that you are there for selling something, but if you do it straight away, our experience is that people will get reluctant. So now it's a perfect moment. Then do the evaluation, see if you have generated leads or you have made the contacts you wanted to do, and find out what you want to do. There is also loads of evaluation models that you can find online. If you need any particular one and you are a bit lost with it, let us know and we will actually train you further. Once the evaluation has been done, draw two columns and write on one what you have done good, to repeat it, and things that you have learned to actually put in practice next time, and also write down what you have done wrong so you don't repeat it in the future as well. Now we have a Q&A session in case you have further questions. If silence means no, apparently. And well, we wanted to do the conclusions with you, but this I think we put it sort of clear. Firstly, connect a lot, make it easy and accessible in order to facilitate contact with people. Marta?
Prepare before going to the event using all the channels of the event, like the hashtag of the event. Also, if the event has an application, an app, a mobile app, in order to matchmake so you can contact with others. See also the site events, and also try to to go to all the possible networking parties also from those days.
Okay, we will write it down, the conclusions, because we wanted to do it open with you. I guess we have done here. Thank you so much for your time. As we said, we will share the material with you with the conclusion done, and if you need further help, further questions or anything else, please let us know. Thank you much.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, bye.
Okay, so can I...
Yes?
Can I ask a question, please?
Sure, yes. Sure.
So before going to this, let's say, fair, how much time do you need for preparation? Because in my opinion, you need at least 6 months, half of year. Is this right?
It depends if you're only an attendant or if you are going to exhibit. If you are exhibiting, then probably it takes about 2 months preparation, I would say.
Minimum.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And if you're just going as an attendee, which is also very helpful, sometimes you don't need a booth in order to explain your product. You can also go with a visitor ticket and then join all the activities. That would take you about two weeks to prepare, or 3 weeks, I would say.
Yeah, but in any case, we recommend to prepare the schedule for the year in advance, so you will know what event will you attend and which one not. This way, you won't have this problem of being preparing the event last minute. So we recommend that maybe.
And if you do not have experience, let's say if this will be your first time, so you still say it's 2 months because you have to reserve also the booth. You have to know where to be in the booth and to have a good location, you know.
Well, it depends on the resources you have. If you have not a lot of people working in it, yes, I mean, 3 months would be the minimum, because it would take more time in order you to learn the because also every trade show has different rules and different methodologies of work. So the sooner you start working in it, the better. Then if you have more resources that you can actually, for example, you can put a person for working this, you can actually make it shorter, because it doesn't take that much. But if you have to produce material, you have to decide where to go, where not, don't to go. I would say yes, 3 months minimum if you don't have experience, because this allows you to work with a wider range of maneuver.
Okay, thank you.
No problem. Further questions? Okay, we assume that. In case you have just think about something in the future, please let us know. You have our contacts. We will super happy to help you in the future. For example, with that meeting that you are preparing, Siga. I think on our side it's done. So we hope to see you in the future in one of those events.
Juan, thank you very much. I wanted to add that perhaps we could share with them the list of events that we identified.
Sure.
You remember the list, because it might be, well, we have identified within the project different events that are taking place in different parts of Europe. And I mean, we could share it with you No problem on that. So you maybe you can see there some events that are of your interest. And as Juan said, in case that you have some specific questions, please you can contact directly Juan or you can contact me, and I will put you in direct contact with them. Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. So thank you very much, and Juan, you will be sending the PPTs to them,
yeah,
together with the link of the events and the thing.
Okay, I will send both in together.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah,
okay.
So, just one thing: the next training session is scheduled. Please, 1 second, let me check. I have the calendar here. Is the 16th of May. Okay, it's about pitching, and it will be at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We will be sending you the invitation via calendar invitation to with information on GoToMeeting. So see you the 16th of May. Bye bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.